Are you guys ready to watch me play some Alien Isolation? And let's just hope that this is actually scary as it being advertised. And that is what I am expecting, you guys. Now, let's see. Head tracking. I do not have the PlayStation eye camera, so nope. It's off the noise detection. And we're going to start off with the medium, you guys, because if it's scary and it is hard, I definitely do not want to show you guys me having a hard time. That is the last thing I want you guys to experience this, but I definitely want you guys to experience the horror with me. If you are not brave enough to take on the challenge of playing Alien Isolation, you can enjoy, you know, me watching, or you can, I should say, you should be able to enjoy me getting scared for you guys. While you can probably get scared with me. You get that? I'm hoping you do. But anyways, you guys, let's just hope that this game is actually scary, because I've been craving for some scary games in a while, since I think the last one I played was the DLC of Outlast Whistleblower, which was a really great game. And if you guys haven't seen me playing that, you should check it out. You know, I have all the parts from the original game and the DLC.
Final report of the commercial starship Nostromo. Third officer reporting. The other members of the crew: Kane, Lambert, Parker, Brett, Ash, and Captain Dallas are dead.
Oh no! Why?
Cargo and ship destroyed. I should reach the frontier in about 6 weeks. With a little luck, the network will pick me up. This is Ripley, last survivor of the Nostromo. Signing off.
Oh yes, you guys, it cannot get any scarier being the last survivor in a station being placed in the middle of space where there's total darkness, nobody to help you out, just you and the aliens. Squaring off to be who survives last, or to say how long you can last. And I'm pretty sure I'll
Ripley.
Be dying a couple of times.
I'm Samuels. I work for the company.
Oh, you don't say.
Hey, it's about your mother. We think we may have found her, Amanda.
Like, you say what?
A commercial vessel, the Anisadora, has recovered what we believe to be the flight recorder unit of the Nostromo.
Where?
Zeta Reticula.
What did it tell you?
We don't know. The unit was taken to Sevastopol Station. It's proprietorial material, so the company wants it to be collected as soon as possible. Sevastopol's a supply depot in the region. It's a permanent freeport facility.
I know what it is.
Transit's arranged. There's a courier ship called the Torrens heading out that way in 2 days. We're going to travel out.
We?
Me and another exec. And you, if you're willing. Look, Ripley. When this job came across my desk, I read the case history. I know why you're working in the region where she went missing. You're still looking, aren't you? I've been cleared to offer you a place on the Torrens if you want to come along. Maybe there'll be some closure for you.
Okay, you guys, one of the things I noticed right now was, you know, we're watching this cutscene, is that the faces of the characters look kind of like someone that has, you know, had Botox on their face, and it just like was a little bit way too much and just looks like kind of like a plastic doll, you know what I mean? You know, it has that feeling. And I don't know, just weird. And also, man, why the hell are they sweating so much? I know that she was working, you know, welding, but it's like they're freaking buckets of sweat, man. That's not normal. And there should be air conditioning on this space station. I mean, they're pretty high tech. Okay, explore the Torrens. And what the hell did I just put my car in here for? I guess to let them know that I'm awake. Oh, this is the pots where they, you know, hibernate and wake up. Get dressed. Oh yeah, she was kind of naked. Or half naked. But I'm getting dizzy. Okay. Now let's get ourselves undressed, you guys. We do not want to be walking in our underwears in the space station. We can't catch a cold. We definitely do not want to catch a cold. Especially how much they've been sweating. She probably needs a shower. Alright. Use registering points to manually save your progress. They will warn you if enemies are nearby. Oh, okay, that's good to know. And let's check this. Green means good. Compound B, C is injector scrap. I have no idea what those items do, but I'm pretty sure. Oh, it says that we can craft things. So let's just quickly save, just for the heck of it, you guys. You know. No, it's just easy as 1, 2, 3. Please wait. You cannot dial this tone at this moment. Please try again. I don't know. I just felt like it was the right time to do that. Okay, this, oh, crew roster. So there's 5 people, including Ripley, which is the girl that we're playing, and everybody signed in. So everybody's accounted for. Oh, this is where we get dressed. No, I wanted to see how she got dressed. You guys killed it. Yes, you guys, I'm a bit of a perv, but what guy is not, right? So now we got dressed. What is our next objective? LM Link. Verline, you on the lookout for a navigation officer? I have a friend that just lost his... Okay, you know what? I don't want to read all of that. It's way too long. I'm pretty sure it's pretty interesting. I myself will read it again later, but you guys can pause it at the moment and, you know, check it out for yourselves and learn more about the game. Alright, so this is a pretty cool spacesuit. And I kind of did not know... Or I didn't see the next objective, so I guess I'll just keep on walking around here and hopefully we find somebody to tell us what the hell to do. Okay, so it doesn't look this way. Let's go this way. Oh, there's another crew member. Let's have a chat.
Taylor, good morning. Ripley, it's certainly not good. I very much doubt it's morning either. Sorry. I feel like death. I don't know how you people put up with hypersleep regularly.
You get used to it.
I don't do long haul very often. Most legal execs don't travel further than the coffee machine.
I'm surprised Weyland-Yutani felt the need to send legal at all.
The loss of the Nostromo and its cargo cost the company a lot of money. It's important we find out what happened. If I can close the case with a conclusive accident report, it'll look great with my superiors. I'm sorry. That was insensitive. I realize... Your mother has been missing for 15 years, and you...
It's okay. We'll both get what we want, right?
Have you seen Samuels? He's probably been up for hours.
I'll catch up with him.
Oh my god, that was some horrible, you know... like, the mouth, how it was, you know, syncing up with her voice was really out of sync, man. That was kind of... It, like, really, you know, took me away from what she was saying. I was, like, staring at her mouth. Like, damn, that thing's out of sync. It's not even going... It's, like, not even syncing up with what she's saying. Oh, my God. That was pretty bad. Let's just hope that maybe that's the only bad thing I'm finding about the game. I mean, it doesn't look great, but it doesn't look bad. I mean, I'm just expecting it to be a good horror game. So, let's just, you know, hopefully it delivers on that aspect. And, you know, we can overlook the little bad things about the game because... There's pretty good stuff that is pretty bad. If that makes sense, right? Yeah, I think it made sense in my head. Alright, guys, so let's just keep on exploring the ship and look for Samuels, which was the guy that we talked in the beginning. I think he's an android because the way he, you know, came off in the beginning. So there he is.
Ah, Ripley.
Samuels, did you wake up early?
Well, I don't really need as much sleep as the rest of you. I was just inspecting the Torrens facilities, a well-maintained ship. I realize it's a very similar model to...
The Nostromo.
Yes, M-class. A later pattern, but close in spec.
I've worked engineering jobs on ships like this.
Of course. Is Taylor up yet? She's not a seasoned traveler. Hypersleep may have been punishing for her.
We talked. She seems nervous.
I hadn't noticed. She's a skilled executive, though. Should help us with any legal issues we might encounter.
Alright, you guys, I'm just gonna keep saying that. It's just some horrible face expression, out of sync voice, and then their mouth does not sync at all.
Looks like we're up.
Oh, man. I just have to say, you guys, that is pretty bad. I'm kind of trying to ignore it, but it's gonna be difficult because it's just... It's so, like, distracting that it's just... What they're saying is just like, I'm sorry, what do you say? Your mouth keeps moving in a weird, you know, it does not move how you, what you're saying. But anyways, you guys, I'm gonna try to keep that in the back of my head and not bring it up, you know, too often, because I feel like I'm gonna bring it up a lot throughout this videos, because I'm planning to make more of this, play the whole game as is possible. All right, guys, but hopefully I do not you know, ruin it for you guys. Hopefully. That is not my intention. Hey, who are you? You person? Are we waiting on somebody else? Because it looks like we are. Just talk already, damn it. She did say... Did anybody say that we're waiting for somebody else? Who is that slacker that is not coming in front of the ship? So I had to restart the game from the last checkpoint, and what you're probably gonna notice is, you know, the girl that was here? In the previous game, she did not move from here, and somehow it did not trigger the next part of our, you know, mission, which was to, like, go into the debriefing room, and everybody was gonna start talking. So it should work this time.
Hope you all had a restful journey.
The Torrens is in very good order for an old M-class captain.
She was a wreck when I bought her. Took a few years and a lot of contracts to refit. She pays for herself now.
You said we're approaching Sevastopol Station. Are we docking?
I believe your contact is Marshal Waits, is that right? I'll hail Sevastopol and arrange boarding with him.
Good. Let's get this done.
Don't worry, Miss Taylor. Routine. In and out. Connor, how are we doing?
SMG loaded and calibrated. Approach vector locked.
Prep comms so I can say hello.
Channel open, Captain.
Does everyone have their briefing documents?
You can watch the approach on the monitors.
Alright, guys. Hopefully I don't meet... Hopefully we don't meet up with another bug like that, man. It's just annoying, man. When you're progressing the story and if something, like, you know, stops you from progressing, I feel like those are the annoying ones, man. Let's just hope that this is the only one. But there might be more, though. Just be prepared. And we head to space, you guys. We're already in space, though.
Switch to monitors. Sevastopol Station.
Is that damage?
Looks like damage.
Punch up 74, tight angle.
Ooh, very tight.
Looks like the dry dock bay is screwed.
He's screwed.
I can't bring the Torrens into that.
Oh, can't do that.
This is a commercial vessel, Torrens out of St. Clair, registration number MSV7760, calling Sevastopol Traffic Control. We're carrying three passengers on a Wayland.
Yutani Bond, you're holding the Nostromo Flight Recorder Unit. We request immediate permission to transfer the passengers port side over. Marshal, this is the Torrens. Say again.
It's like, we can't fucking hear you, bitch. It's like, speak more clear. Hello?
The station's comms seem pretty screwed up, so I fitted Samuel's suit with a radio booster. I can only keep the Torrens in transit for 24 hours.
You'll have heard from us by then.
Safe trip.
Stand by. My contract doesn't cover bloody spacewalks. It's the only option, and it's perfectly safe if you do what I tell you.
You get the feeling that Taylor is gonna be the first one to go down, because especially the one that is the the one more scared and nervous. It's the one of the first ones to go in scary, you know, scary games and movies.
Fuck happened here? My God, Ripley. You're doing good, Tim.
I saw that
just
coming. She's gonna be the first one to go. Damn.
Ripley, hold on.
Oh shit. She like got swung past to the other side. Oh, I'm pretty sure she went like got sucked into the darkness of space.
Taylor, respond, anybody.
Samuel should be good. Taylor, we can only hope.
Okay.
All right, you guys, and we go into the, is this the Nostradamus or is it the vast pool? I don't know. I think I'm a little bit confused, but it'll probably be clearer once we get inside and we find more information. Because it wasn't the Nostradamus, the one in the beginning from the introduction that she was naming people's, you know, that had died and that she was in there. So maybe it's this place. I'm pretty sure it is because it looks huge. Maybe it's a section of it. Hiding is only ever a temporary solution. Ooh, does that mean we can fight back? In addition to callback codes, the security access turner can also match frequency fluctuations. I have no idea what that means and what it is for. Conserve your ammunition as you never know when you might need it. Oh, okay, so we are going to have a way to fight back. Okay, it's always good to, you know, be able to fight back but have a limitation, which, you know, makes it a survival horror. I am ready, guys. I am so ready. I'm pumped to kill some aliens and run away from them too. But so far we've been like a good amount of time in the game, we still haven't seen any, you know, horror aspect. I guess, you know, they're introducing the story and then we're gonna start seeing some alien action, which I don't mind, you know. It's always to have a good story, you know, because not a lot of horror games have a good story, because I mean the point is to get scared. Alright, now where do I go? It says find help. Oh yeah, this is always a good thing to do. And what is this, shiny lights? I'll just press X. Oh, it looks like I need to put my spacesuit away before I start walking around the station. Alright, alright. I was gonna say that was gonna be pretty annoying the way, you know, we saw through her with that helmet. Wow, it's pretty dark in here. Okay, good, good. Very good. I did not like the darkness. It's a little bit too unsettling, you guys. Alright, so we see a safe station. Let me just quickly look around. And wait, what? Let's see if there's anything like we can find here. Views. Oh, I can run. Cool, cool. I definitely wanted to run earlier, but I guess it didn't let me. Alright, let's go, you guys. Let's go to the other way. Let's go. Okay, there's a lot of trembling. No, the lights. Oh, okay. I was gonna say, man, it's getting way too dark in this bitch. Oh! Yeah. That is definitely not a go. Oh, what the? Is this thing open? How the hell do I crouch? Oh! Oh, I can climb into it. And I also learned how to crouch. Okay, that's a good thing to know in one. I was wondering if you can crouch on this, man. I was like, I was only standing up, but oh. Yeah, he definitely don't like it when it gets dark in here. Alright, man. Red lights in horror games are never a good thing. Alright, guys. My senses are a little bit heightened, but I'm still not scared, though. Yeah, I don't think it's a good idea to go that way. It's a lot of going on in here, but doesn't seem like anybody's alive. Alright, you know what? Let's quickly look at this. Just so maybe we can get an idea of what is going on. Yeah. Of course, it's corrupted. Alright, so do we go that way? I mean, we can't go this way. There's nothing in their use. I'm pretty sure I can't go that way. So my only option is going forward. Oh, shit! Alright. That kind of like scared me a little bit, just because it surprised me. Not because I was scared. I thought someone got my leg and pulled me down. I was like, oh shit. Alright. Alright, now it looks like it's getting good, you guys.
Damn.
Yeah, I was gonna say that too. I was like, god damn, it's dark in here. Okay, I think I grabbed the flare. Alright, open circle. And then activate. Alright, it's good to know that we got flares. Again, it's so damn dark in this. I guess I can't go this way. I thought there was gonna be something to do in there. But apparently not, you guys. Not. Alright, let's crouch down again. Let's just hope that something is not hiding in here, you guys. Oh, there's smoke. I think the station is burning because of that explosion. So we shouldn't be being here too long. I'm running. I am running. Okay, let's just crouch down again. Panicking never solves anything, guys. Every time there's a disaster, people tell you not to panic, but I will panic a little bit. All right, let's open this. Charge packs. What are those for? Wait, is that to collect something? Oh, it's an injector. Didn't I get one of those earlier in the beginning? All right, doesn't seem like this is the place, you guys. Let's go back. Oh my goodness. What the hell? I've never seen this. Lower the ramp. What did I lower? Oh. Oh, okay. Oh, okay. So this is the place that I was like, where do I need to go? Can I hold this while I'm climbing up? Let's go. I guess I put my flare away somehow when it's still lit up. I'm sure it's not burning my pants. What? Did she just throw it away? The hell, there's music! No, I'm gonna get a copyright for that! Alright, so make sure to be safe than sorry. Alright, you guys. Damn, it's dark in here.
Hello? Anyone here?
Okay, so it doesn't look like anybody is, and if there is something here, they don't speak English. Because they definitely would have said something. There's a lot of writing in the walls that I noticed earlier. Touchpad to see the map. Okay. So I'm assuming that I'm the white circle and the exclamation mark. It's either something dangerous or what, or there, I have to do something in there. Alright, so let's just go ahead and... What the hell is this? It says 200 kg joules of generator. So I'm pretty sure this is energy. Alright, let's go with the X. Let's press this bad boy and power up the levels. Okay. Oh, it seems like that worked, you guys. That definitely worked. Whoa. Okay, so I shouldn't probably need the flares at the moment, but I'm pretty sure I'll put it away. Let's access this and see if there's any more information that probably can be helpful, unlike earlier. Alright, guys. I'll just leave it. Oh, there's a quote in there. 034. Okay, so we're gonna definitely keep that in mind. Alright, guys, I'll be making this the stopping point. And if you wanna say anything that came up in the game, or you know, anything about the game that you wanna, you know, express your feelings about, you know, let me know by putting it in the comment box below. And as well as if you liked the video, might as well hit that like. If you haven't done so already, you might as well hit that subscribe to keep yourself more updated for future content and for the next part. And remember that this was Fear D. I'll be seeing you guys later.